or not, ano man ang relihiyon natin, ay alam natin siguro naman ang manalangin. Amen? And we know that prayer is how we communicate to our God. And without communication, alam natin sa bawat relasyon, kapag if we don't communicate or very less ang communication, lalo na pag magkalayo tayo sa isa't isa, our relationship might be in jeopardy or might be in danger. Because communication will strengthen every relationship. Ano man klaseng relasyon, mag-asawa man, magkapatid, whatever relationship, we need communication. And halimbawa sa husband and wife, di ba? Usually, usong-uso sa atin ang isa ay malayo dahil nga nasa abroad, ang isa ay nasa Pilipinas. At ang pag-communicate is so vital, very important, dahil ito yung nagpapasigla sa isang relasyon. And when you stop communicating, nako, delikado, baka mamaya iba na ang kakommunicate ni Mrs. or ni Mr. kapag hindi tayo constant na makipag-communicate sa ating mga asawa. Amen? And before kayong mag-asawa, as I remember also in my experience, di ba kapag boyfriend, girlfriend pa lang kayo, halos yung lalo na ngayon na meron tayong mga gadgets na gagamitin, you always want to listen na pagkagising mo, maririnig mo agad ang boses ng iyong mahal. Good morning, mahal. How are you? Kumusta ang tulog? Sa kalagitnaan. Every hour, you long for his voice. You long yung communication ninyo sa bawat isa. Especially when you are courting your girlfriend or your wife-to-be. Nandun yung constant na communication natin sa bawat isa. Amen? Pero after na mag-asawa, several years, nako, nung nagkaanak at nagkalayo, medyo na nabawasan, hindi na nagkakapag-communicate until na, syempre, masisira ang relasyon kapag walang communication. So, ganun din po sa ating Panginoon. We need to communicate with Him constantly through prayer. Amen. But so sad to see that a lot of Christians was accepted Yeshua 10 years, 15 years, pero kapag sabihan mo na, mag-lead ka nga ng prayer, or lalo na kapag yung instant na may group of, meron kayong group meeting or something like that, na or celebration, sabihan mo na, sis, ipag-lead mo nga ng prayer na po. Diba, nagtuturuan pa, huwag muna ngayon. Si sister, si brother, mas magaling siya. Why? Bakit kaya? Ang tagal na natin Kristiyano. Bakit sa palagay nyo, hindi tayo confident? Dahil siguro wala pang kaayusan tayo manalangin, or kulang tayo kung paano ba, ano ba ang pattern, paano ba ang umpisahan, ano ba ang words na sasabihin. So that's why Jesus, the disciples also asked the Lord Yeshua to teach them how to pray. And this morning, we are going to learn. It might be a basic teaching, but it is important to remind always every one of us this basic teaching of the Lord on how, the pattern of on how to pray. So, introduction pa lang yun. Introduction, prayer is talking to God. It is very vital in the spiritual life of Christians. It is the most powerful weapon any person can wield. Its power is greater than any man's finances, intelligence, education, politics, or social standing. It is one of the five tools of Christian growth. Yet, this tool is underutilized and greatly misapplied. Many profess to be Christian and do not have a powerful prayer life. Others say their prayers go unanswered. Did you ever ask why? Tinanong ba natin bakit? Bakit parang hindi nakakarating ang ating panalangin sa ating Panginoon? We must know that once we receive Yeshua or Lord, the Lord Jesus in our hearts, we are which is prayer, and He taught us how we should pray. So we must speak, talk, and pray to Him daily. Amen. Hallelujah. So in Matthew chapter 6, verse 7, Yeshua warned His disciples, gaya ng nabasa natin kanina, at basahin ko uli, verse 7, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. I remember when I was a child, although I grown up in a Christian family, so wala akong experience sa mga ibang mga religion about prayer. So, but when I joined sa aking mga friends na sumama ako sa kanilang parang novena or something like that na mga bahay-bahay na mag-lead ng mga prayer. So I heard how they pray na meron silang yung rosary, and then I'm not against any religion. I'm just setting an example kasi ito nga yung topic natin ngayon. And now there are yung paulit-ulit, Holy Mary, Mother of God, yun, ganun, yung mga paulit-ulit na prayer hanggang sa ilang times. And this is what Jesus has said in verse 7 na huwag tayong manalangin na paulit-ulit na, di ba, wala na yung sense, hindi na galing. Ang tendency is hindi na galing sa puso natin because we memorize it. So, parang kahit na nagalakad ka, pwede mong sabihin yon at hindi talaga galing sa puso. And that is what Jesus had rebuked and opposed. Na kailangan, when we pray, it should come into our hearts. Yeshua warned His disciples not to pray with meaningless repetition. The Lord's Prayer is not a set of or group of words to repeat. It is fine to recite it, as we recite many parts of the scriptures. It is certainly fine to memorize it and to rehearse it in our minds and meditate it on our hearts, but it is not a substitute for our own prayers, but a pattern or guide as we pray. Okay lang po na minsan gawin natin prayer itong mga the Lord's Prayer, pero more on tinuro ng binigay ng Panginoon ito for us to follow a pattern wherein magiging guide natin kung paano tayo manalangin in our personal prayer life. Amen. So Yeshua said, this is then how you should pray. So number one, Our Father in chapter 6 verse 9. Diba when we alam natin na lahat tayo, alam natin manalangin, but then iba-iba po. Kung we know as Christians, we know that we have one God and real God, pero ang ibang mga tao, may mga Diyos sila na iba-iba. Merong Diyos ang animal, merong Diyos ang son, but we know for a fact as Christians that we have one God, who is our Father in heaven. Kaya, kailangan natin i-address ang ating panalangin. Di ba kapag mag-pray tayo, Almighty Father, ganun. We start with an address na the prayer begins by addressing God as our Father. The word Father stresses an intimate relationship. We should know that our Father, that our God doesn't listen to all prayers, but He only and particularly listens to the prayers of His children. Amen? As I always say, na lahat tayo nilalang ng Panginoon, that, but not all of us are children of God. Sabi niya sa John 1:12, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words, but as many as receive Him, to them He gave the right to become children of God, even to those who believe in his name. So it is very clear in the Bible, hindi po namin ito sinasabi or hindi ko ito sinasabi, but the Bible says na kung sino lang ang tumanggap at manampalataya sa ating Panginoon, sila lang ang may karapatan na maging anak ng Diyos. At kung tayo ay tumanggap, we are free and privileged to call God our Father. Amen. If we truly accepted the Lord Yeshua in our hearts, only then can we have the right to call God our Father. Father is a relationship word. It includes the concept of care. responsibility, discipline, hope and dreams of one's children, respect, authority, and blessing. Di ba, even in our, sa mga tatay natin dito sa ibabaw ng mundo, our biological father, meron tayo kanta kanyang father, biological father, hindi pwedeng kahit sino tawagin mong daddy, baka mamaya, oh, hindi kita anak, sabihin. Unless na alam mo na siya talaga ang iyong tatay in sa dito sa mundo. Or minsan we call out yung daddy sa yung halimbawa tatay ng asawa mo. Yes, we call him dad also or father or papa. Pero hindi lahat ng tatay ay pwede mong tawaging ama unless ikaw talaga ay anak niya. Ganon din po sa ating Panginoon. Hindi lahat, kahit lahat ay nagpre-pray, ay everyone knows how to pray and everyone is praying, but not all prayers are being heard or be pinapakinggan ng Panginoon. Only, sabi niya dito, kung sino lang yung anak niya ang may karapatan na tumawag sa ating Panginoon as Father. So since God is our Father, we can approach Him anytime we need. But we should do so with a sense of reverence, acknowledging that He is holy and we are in awe. Even to our Father dito sa ibabaw ng mundo. Diba? We respect them as our Father. Meron tayong respeto yung pagmamahal sa kanila. How much more to our Father who is in heaven. So Romans 8:15, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that we are His children and we are free to call Him our Abba, Father. Number two, who art, so diba, number one is our Father, and number two, who art in heaven. So, diba sa ating pagsulat, kung meron tayong sulat na ilalagay or address, kailangan isulat natin ang pangalan niya at tapos address, dahil siyempre kailan, asan ba siya? So, our Lord Yeshua teaches us to pray to God who art in heaven, which adds infinity to our understanding of God. Di ba alam natin na ang Panginoon, He is in heaven. Although, His Holy Spirit is with us and we can approach Him anytime, but for everyone to know, God is in heaven. Sabi nga niya sa, though King Solomon built a temple for God, he prayed sa 1 Kings 8, verse 27, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. But will God really dwell on earth? The heavens, even the highest heaven, cannot contain you. How much less this temple I have built. So yes, God is greater than His creation, but the heavens is a way to understand the greatness of God's dwelling. Yun yung ano na, we have to know that He is in heaven, that He hears our prayer even though He is there. Amen. Number three, hallowed be your name. This is a very important part of our prayer. The Greek word is hagiazo, which means to treat as holy. Reverence. So hallowed comes from the English word holy. This word reminds us that our Father is holy, set apart from sin, that he can be the father of sinners, and yet He is holy. Diba, when we pray, though we are privileged to call Him our Father, we should never forget that He is holy, blameless, and exalted. Our Lord Yeshua teaches us to call God our Father, recognize His exalted place of dwelling, and reverence Him. We should never misuse of or profane the name of God. So hallowed means holy. Siya ay dapat nating galangin. So when we pray, what should be our, ano dapat ang ugali natin? How should we treat our God in our prayers? Because He is holy, so we should treat Him as a holy God. We should, dito po na, dito natin ginagawa yung pag-worship, di ba? When we pray, after nating i-address na our Father in heaven, dito natin isabihin yung mga attributes niya bilang ating Panginoon. That, Lord, we thank you that you are our Almighty God, you are our provider, you are our omniscient God. Doon natin sabihin lahat yung mga attributes na alam natin para sa Panginoon. Amen? So, hallowed be your name means that we are to approach the Father not only with familiarity but also with reverence and respect for His greatness and holiness. In this, we focus in worshiping who He is. His attributes as powerful, almighty, omniscient, omnipotent, and an awesome God. It is also in this part that we give thanks. We give Him thanks for all His goodness and faithfulness into our lives. Huwag po tayong dumiretso agad na, Lord, pagalingin mo ako, or kailangan ko ito. Kailangan ko talaga to, Lord. Kailangan ugaliin natin na magpasalamat, i-appreciate ang Panginoon for His goodness in our lives. Dito sa part na to, we are free to give thanks na kahit maliit o malaking bagay na ginawa ng Panginoon, na pre-provide na Panginoon sa atin, dapat nating i-express by giving thanks, worshiping His name. Amen? Hallelujah! Diba, even in our, sa ating mga sinusuportahan, or halimbawa sa Pilipinas, kung pinapadalhan natin, diba, we appreciate na magpasalamat sila, hindi lang yung hingi ng hingi. So, di ba yung minsan nakaka-encourage na mas lalo mo pang bigyan or tulungan yung tao na marunong magpasalamat. Na, ate, salamat, or mama, salamat sa binigay mo, salamat dahil hindi ka magsasawa na tumutulong sa amin. Di ba yung nakakataba ng puso? For that simple thanks is a big thing for those who did help. Amen? Malaking bagay yan. And lalo na kapag ina-appreciate nila yung effort mo, yung pagod mo dito sa abroad, or yung pagod mo bilang isang tumutulong sa kanila. The same true with God. He loves na ina-appreciate natin sa that. He loves to be worshipped and to be reverent, to give Him the highest reverence because He is worthy of our praise. He is the source of our life and the giver of our everything, kung ano ang meron tayo. Amen. Dahil sabi nga sa Psalms 96 verse 9, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. Niya dito, God is a God who provides, and so He is worthy to receive. Dahil tayo ay create niya, karapat dapat lang na ibigay natin sa Kanya lahat ng pasasalamat, lahat ng reverence, respect bilang ating Ama at ating Creator, Provider, and everything. Amen. Hallelujah. Number 4. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. This is found in chapter 6, verse 10. So God is a sovereign in heaven and on earth. His will always prevail in the end. Nonetheless, asking Him to prioritize His will over ours affirms our agreement that His ideas and methods are superior to ours. It expresses kingdom of heaven is at hand. Sabi niya sa Matthew chapter 3 verse 2. And Yeshua takes up the same message in verse 17. He sends out His disciples with the authority to do miracles and proclaim to all places that the kingdom of God is at hand. Ganon din po sa Luke chapter 10 verse 9 and 11. So the kingdom of God comes when Yeshua proclaims God's reign and demonstrate that reign by preaching good news to the poor, freedom from the prisoners, sight for the blind, release for the oppressed, and the jubilee day of the Lord. The kingdom here is Yeshua, Jesus. But it will come fully and completely when Yeshua returns again to reign over all as King and Lord. Amen. Sabi niya, the kingdom of God is at hand. Nandyan na po. Nandyan na si Yeshua. But it will come fully and completely when Yeshua returns again to reign. Sabi niya po sa Revelation 11, verse 15, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. Then the seventh angel sounded, and there were loud voices in heaven saying, the kingdom of this world have become the kingdom of our Lord and of Christ Jesus, and he shall reign forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. So, second is your will be done. Amen. So, we all... Amen. So, as I said, your will be done. This petition is a condition for prayer that all our prayers conform first to God's will. How can we pray the kind of prayer that Yeshua wants of us and still ask for our selfish desires, which is clearly contrary to God's revealed will in the Bible? Part of the teaching on the pattern of prayer is determine God's will and pray along on those lines. Our request must be centered on what God desires. Di po ba? Minsan, sabihin natin na, Lord, kalooban mo ba na bumili ako nito? Di ba? We always, Lord, gusto ko ito, pero dapat meron pa rin tayo yung prayer na, if this is your will, O Lord, kailangan isalin natin lagi ang Panginoon. If this is your will, then bibilhin ko. Or if this is your will, O Lord, then pupunta ako. Amen? So we should always ask God's will, or mag-submit tayo sa will ng Panginoon in every decision we make or every actions that we will do. Amen? So 1 John 5:14 and 15, now this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He will hear us. And if we know that He hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of Him. Amen. Humanly, Yeshua did not want to suffer the brutal torture and death that awaited Him. Yet, He still prayed that God's will be done, not His own. Yeshua always put God the Father first. He always approached Him with a yielded and humble attitude. So kung ang ating Panginoong Yeshua ay nag-submit sa kanyang Ama, how much more to us? We have to always submit to the will of the Lord, kung ano man ang plano natin, kung ano man ang bawat gawin natin or bawat action natin sa buhay. Amen. Because God is in control. Dahil tinanggap natin siya, so let us allow Him to always work in our lives, na His will be done in our lives. Number 5, give us this day our daily bread. Matatagpuan sa chapter 6, verse 11. The implication here is we are to come to God with our daily needs. When we say give us, that doesn't mean that we don't work for our living. Hindi ibig sabihin na magtambay ka na lang dyan. Anyway, God will provide. Hindi po. Amen. Hallelujah. But we recognize God as our provider. Jesus teaches us to come and be dependent upon our Father and to bring Him our daily needs. He does want us to get into the habit of relying upon the Father for everything. Amen. Kung binigay ng Panginoon yung 1 million na hinihingi mo, o di, hindi mo na siya tatawagin. Diyahin lang dyan na eh. Everything is there. Gumasta ka na lang ng gumastos. Pero, God is not giving us yung kung ano yung makakasama sa atin. Binibigay niya kung ano lang. Gusto niya kasi na every day we come to Him with humble hearts na, Lord, kung wala ka, Panginoon, wala akong kakainin or wala ako. So He wants us to be dependent on Him, not only in our needs, but in every area na kailangan natin siya. Amen. Our every needs. Amen. If we, sabi nga, meron nga kasabihan na kapag may tinanim, may aanihin. Amen. We acknowledge that God is our provider. Pero bilang anak niya, are we also giving our part? Halimbawa, our tithes. Diba? Kung binibigay ba natin yung tithes natin, binibigay ba natin yung due for Him? Diba kapag, kung alam natin na we are giving, we are faithful in our tithes, so we are also, yung bang kapag kailangan na natin, Lord, eto na, pwede bang mag-withdraw sa aking mga, dahil kailangan ko na, Lord, diba? Diba you are, you, hindi ka mas mahihiya sa Panginoon na mag-withdraw, na humingi ng provision niya dahil alam mo that you are giving Him His part, kung ano yung para sa Kanya, like our tithes. Diba kapag may dineposit ka, may ma-withdraw. Ang problema sa atin, hingi tayo ng hingi. We are always asking, demanding na, Lord, kailangan ko talaga gawa ng tuition yung anak ko ganito. But are we giving Him what is due for Him? Meron ba tayong i-withdraw? Kung binibigay mo lang 100-100, tapos humingi ka ng 5,000, edi, kung malaki yung dineposit natin, then, malaki din yung ibibigay ng Panginoon. Amen! Give and take yan, mga kapatid. Kung merong tinanim, may aanihin. Kung may dineposit, may withdraw. Gusto natin, withdraw ng withdraw. Na wala naman tayong dineposit sa Kanya. Amen. Hallelujah. So God wants us to be obedient in all areas. So that, hindi rin siya maging marami na ibigay kung ano ang kailangan natin. Minsan, napaka-demanding pa natin, now na! Diba? Now na po, Lord. Pero, kapag yung tithes natin, hirap na hirap tayong bumunod. Hindi muna ngayon kasi kailangan matapos ko yung kusina ng bahay ko. Kailangan ganito, ganito, ganon. So, yun nga, we have to give what is due to Him para the blessings also will flow whenever we ask Him. So since it is God who gives us the ability to earn a living, then in real sense, it is He who gives us our daily bread. Yeshua is teaching us to look to the Father for every provision. Sa Matthew 6, chapter 31 and 32, Holy Spirit bless your holy words. So do not worry, saying, what shall we eat or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows what you need. Minsan, di ba, dahil sa sitwasyon natin, worry talaga tayo, paano na? Wala nang bigas, wala nang ganito. We always worry. And yun yung time na kailangan nating magdepende sa Panginoon. Lord, alam po namin, pinabayaan pa na po ba tayo ng Panginoon? Never, di ba? Kahit napaka-disobedient tayo, kahit marami tayong mga kasalanan, never did God abandon us or hinding-hindi niya tayo pinabayaan. Amen! Number 6, forgive our debts. Ito po ay isa rin na mahalaga sa part of our prayer na we should ask God to forgive and cleanse us bago tayo magpatuloy sa ating mga prayer requests. Amen? Kasi minsan sa atin, kapag hindi tayo lumabas, nandun tayo sa room natin, wala naman akong kasalanan na ginawa. Wala naman akong, di ba? Ang akala natin, we did not sin dahil hindi tayo lumabas, wala tayong nakausap. Pero, hindi mo alam na, sa yung pag-iisa sa yung room, naisip mo na nag-flashback tayo sa yung ginawa ng best friend mo na inagaw ang iyong mahal. So, nagalit ka ngayon. Kahit na doon ka sa kwarto mo, naalala mo lang dahil nag-throwback yung mga pictures, nagkasala ka na doon. So, sometimes we are not aware na in our action, in our thoughts, nagkakasala pala tayo. Halimbawa sa yung pag-iisa, hindi na ako lalabas para less ang pagkakasala. Pero as you are viewing in your mobile, nag-scan ka, naku, may mga ball pornography, hindi mo na malaya na natuon na pala yung mata doon, nabighani ka sa mga sexing picture, So, nagkasala na naman tayo doon. So, we always ask. It is important that we always ask the Holy Spirit to search our heart, Lord. Ano man ang nakikita mong kasalanan sa puso ko, hinihingi ko ng kapatawaran. Para yung prayer natin is walang blockage, walang mag-block para makarating sa ating Panginoon. So, unconfessed sins block our communication with God. Pag hindi natin to kinonfess sa Panginoon, it will block. Di ba kapag meron yung time na kapag nanalangin tayo, parang hindi nakarating, parang nasa bubong lang ba, na hindi natin ma-feel yung presence ng Panginoon. Why? Because of the sin na hindi natin na-confess, hindi natin na-iningi ng tawad. So confessing them and accepting God's forgiveness restores our fellowship with Him. It is always important to ask the Holy Spirit to search our hearts and reveal whatever sins we committed. Ask God to cleanse and forgive us. Sabi nga sa 1 John 1:9, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Amen. God has seen a man commit sin imaginably. Imaginable. Our confession will not shock Him, but it will set us free from the deadly cycle of sin, pain, and ultimately death. Be humble and repent and ask God for God's mercy and forgiveness. So, forgive us our debts. And next is, as we forgive our debtors. So, forgiveness is sometimes terribly difficult.
Amen.
It is usually not so hard to forgive people we don't know. Magaling magpatawad kung walang connection sa'yo yung taong nagkasala sa'yo. Halimbawa, namit mo lang sa kung saan-saan, tapos nagkasala sa'yo, yung bang nasaktan ka, parang hindi masyado masakit sa'yo dahil hindi mo naman siya ka-close. Amen? Pero the people with whom we have relationship of trust, who turn on us, who betray our trust, those people are the hardest to forgive. Like husbands, like wives, father, mother, children, relatives, our best friend, our close friend, our leaders, and even our pastors. They can turn on us and wound us deeply. An unwillingness to forgive when we are capable of forgiveness evidences a hard heart toward God. As yung message ko nung Bible study, when I had messages na kailangan natin mag-forgive, agad-agad merong nag-message na paano, pas na, ang asawa ko lagi akong niloloko hanggang ngayon, paulit-ulit, hayun, nawala na naman sa bahay. So, sabi niya, paano, i-forgive ko pa rin siya, tanggapin ko pa rin siya? So, I said, yes, because dahil yun ang sinabi ng Bible. Mahirap, it is not, lalo na pag nandun na tayo sa sitwasyon that we are wounded so hard, masakit at malalim yung sugat na dinulot niya, mahirap i-release ang forgiveness. But then, gaya nga ng sabi ng Panginoon, we have to forgive 70 times 7. Amen, mga kapatid? Amen. It's really hard to release forgiveness. Pero, yung blessing, kapag finorgive, ni-release natin yung forgiveness, wala na sa atin. The blessing will flow in us. At kung siya ay hindi nag-release ng forgiveness, then he is accountable or she is accountable.
Amen. Amen.
Sa kasalanan, na sa forgiveness na hindi niya ni-release. So for us, para maging maganda ang flow ng Christian life natin, ng blessings ng Panginoon, we should release. How painful it may be, masakit man, malalim man, pero as the Bible says, we have to release forgiveness. Lagi natin ito na sinasabi whenever we go to the church na yun, minememorize natin, we always quote na as we forgive those who sins against us and lead us. Pero, nandun pala, may kinikimkim tayo. Madaling sabihin, but pag nandun ka na sa sitwasyon na grabe nang nasaktan kayo, yes, it is difficult, but then, ask the Lord to help us to release forgiveness on the person who had caused us the pain. Amen. Hallelujah. So, the path of health is forgiveness. The path of healing is forgiving. True forgiveness does not minimize the sin or the hurt, nor excuse the sinner. True forgiveness chooses not to hold the sin against the sinner any longer. You may be freshly wounded and find your anger too massive to forgive. The injustice may be ongoing. The outrage constant, but we must forgive those who have hurt us even if they lack remorse. Because our Heavenly Father will not forgive us and it blocks the blessings of God to flow in us. Amen. Sabi nga sa Matthew 6, 14 to 15, for if you forgive men their trespasses, your Heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Amen. Amen. Maliwanag po ba sa forgive, forgive, forgive? Amen. Clear as the liwanag ng buwan. Number 7, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Alam natin na temptation is everywhere. Temptation sa pagkain, temptation sa lust, temptation sa mga magagandang tanawin, or, naku, yung sapatos ko, ano na, nakanganga na, kailangan ko ng ano. Diba, maraming temptation. And, sabi nga niya, sa James 1:13 verse 14, when tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does He tempt anyone. But each one is tempted when by his own evil desires, he is dragged away and enticed. Amen. So sometimes we Christians flirt with temptation. Minsan tayo kasi yung nag-flirt. Alam ba natin yung nag-flirt? Kumbaga may crush ka, nag-flirt mo siya. Yung bang ikaw na mismo yung lumalapit na pinapahiwatig mo na gusto mo siya. Amen. Ganon tayo minsan sa temptation. Kaya, yung temptation, minsan sinusunggaban na tayo. Amen? So, we don't exactly seek temptation, but we are attracted to sinful things, and so we sort of wink of them. Our resistance is low. We are being dragged away and enticed by our own evil desire, as James puts in. This prayer, and lead us not into temptation, helps teach us how important it is for us to stop flirting with sin but to actively flee and resist it. Pag andyan na, aba, eh, tumakbo. Huwag harapin, takbuhan. Amen? Hindi eh. Pero, ang ginawa, niyakap pa. Ayun tuloy. Amen. Nagkaroon na ng junior. Tapos, ang masama, na natulfo. Ay, nako. So, nasira ang pamilya. Ganun po ang temptation. Temptation is very attractive. Wow. Talagang katakam-takam. Talagang the devil will do all his best para maging gawing attractive yung temptation na yan. Para tayo naman na medyo mahina-hina sa mga temptation na po. Naintindihan ako kasi kailangan ko eh. Naintindihan ako kasi malayong asawa ko. Hindi po, hindi excuse na malayong ating asawa. Kailangan maging busy tayo sa pagbasa, sa pagpray para ma-divert yung ano natin sa lust, sa desire ng flesh natin. Amen. So James 4:7 said, submit yourself then to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Submit. It is by submission to God that the devil will flee. Kailang kapag nakita ng demonyo na nako, medyo mahirap tong item. Matigas talagang ano, masyadong close sa kaniyang Diyos. Aba, eh talagang ano, mag-surrender na ang kaaway at lalayuan na tayo. Amen. Na alam din ng kaaway kung malakas tayo, kung mahina tayo sa temptasyon or kung, and it is through prayer na kailangan natin yung strength ng Panginoon to resist that temptation. Some of us may be ashamed of our secret sins, afraid to open up to God. My dear brethren, there is nothing we have done or said or thought that can surprise our Father. The miracle of the cross is that He cares about us in spite of our rebelliousness and disobedience. This part of the Lord's Prayer reminds us to call upon the Father for strength when we are tempted. We are not to fight a secret war against sin. The Father wants us to be our continual prayer partner. We know He knows our weakness and wants us to free and make us whole. Amen. But God does test us. He allows circumstances that stress and try us to make us pliable enough that He can remold us into His own image. Sabi nga sa James 1, 2, and 3, Holy Spirit, bless your holy words. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. And sabi niya, those who persevere till the end will receive the gift or will be in heaven. Amen. So deliver us from the evil one. Ito na yung pinaka-last. There's a whole spiritual world out there. And the reality is we need God's strength to get by. That means we should stay in tune with the Holy Spirit to help guide us and direct us. We should regularly be praying for God's strength to overcome whatever it is we are facing. We cannot do it on our own. We need God's strength. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So that He will deliver us from the evil one. So doxology, yung last is for thine, for yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Always end our prayers by giving Him thanks, giving Him back the honor, the glory that only belongs to Him. Amen. So before we go to our conclusion, I am inviting everyone who had heard this prayer, gaya po ng sinabi ko kanina, God listens only to the prayer of His children. And if we don't have relationship to God as our Father, kung hindi po natin siya tinanggap bilang Panginoon at tagapagligtas, we may be praying a lot of prayer, rendering kahit paluluhod-luluhod tayo ng maghapon if we do not have relationship to our Lord Jesus. If kung hindi natin siya tanggapin bilang Panginoon at tagapagligtas, ay hindi po niya tayo, hindi niya maririnig ang ating panalangin at hindi niya maririnig kung ano yung mga kailangan natin. So I challenge everyone who don't have relationship to our Lord Jesus na samahan ako, or I will say a prayer and you can follow after me, and gawin mo ito bilang personal prayer mo, bilang pagtanggap sa ating Panginoong Jesus, Yeshua Hamasaya, into our hearts. Amen. So let us pray. You can follow after me. Jesus, I believe You are the Son of God, that You died on the cross to rescue me from sin and death, and to restore me to the Father. I choose now to turn from my sins, my self-centeredness, and every part of my life that does not please You. Forgive and purify me from all my sins, O Lord. I now open the door of my heart and accept You, Jesus, as my Lord, Savior, and Master of my life. I give myself to You, O God. I receive Your forgiveness and ask You to take Your right place in my life as my Lord and Savior. Reign in my heart, fill me with Your love and Your life, and help me to become a person who will obey You and be faithful to You. Write my name in the book of life so that I will be with You when the day that You come again. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen. So, congratulations. If you had prayed this prayer of acceptance, simple lang, mga kapatid. Welcome to the family of God. You are now a child of God. And you can talk to God through prayer anytime, anywhere you want. So, conclusion na po tayo. Prayer is a personal, private, one-on-one conversation between you and your Creator. The Lord's Prayer, given to us by the Lord Himself, gives us a great framework and a pattern to follow. Let us always come to God with a humble and obedient heart. God will never turn His back on us if we faithfully do His will in our lives. He listens to our prayers and will surely answer us if we diligently seek Him and pray Him with humble and contrite heart. God is expecting more from us, His children. Let us always approach God as a friend, a loving Father who listens to us. He is always there, available for us at all times. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. So let us all bow down our heads for our closing prayer. Hallelujah. Purihin ka, Panginoon. We praise you. We thank you for your greatness. We thank you for your words that reminds us again, O Lord God, on how we should approach you through prayer. Salamat, Panginoon, sa muli, O Lord God, pinaalala mo sa amin, O Lord God, kung paano kami matuto, O Lord God, na makipag-communicate sa inyo with the right motives, with the right words, O Lord God. And Lord, I pray, O God, that you would teach us always on how to pray. Help us, O Lord God, to be more closer to you through our prayer. We know, O Lord God, that this is our backbone of our Christian life. And so, Lord, tanggalin mo, Panginoon, yung mga katamaran namin. Tanggalin mo, Panginoon, yung mga unfaithfulness namin sa aming prayer life, O Lord God. Amen. Teach us always to be prayerful and to always come to you with humble hearts, O Lord God. Amen. I decree and declare blessing upon blessing for all those who listen to your words, O God. And I declare healing to those who need healing, O Lord God, in the mighty name of our Lord Yeshua. And I also pray and decree and declare, O Lord, provision for jobs sa mga nangailangan ng trabaho in the mighty name of our Lord Yeshua. Salamat, Panginoon. We give you all the praises, the glory, the highest adoration that belongs to your name, alone, our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, we pray. Amen. 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 So, shalom everyone. God bless us all.
Amen.